Okay, now let's take a look at kita punya SCM process flow. Okay, SCM of course yang daripada PBM ataupun yang kita perlu buat if it's included in our contract lah. Okay, first of all, the key accounts manager, site engineer ataupun site coordinator needs to key in an SCM summary list. Okay. This SCM summary list is quite similar to the PPM summary list. Okay, like I said earlier, the SCM summary is quite similar to PPM summary. In fact, they are actually derived from the PPM summary lah, or the remarks from the PPM. Okay, example, if you the site coordinator or key in the PPM summary, you guys remember tadi yang ada tiga remarks tadi. Okay, so what the site coordinator needs to do is she needs to transfer it to an SCM summary. Okay, for the time being, you just need to create the SCM work order. Okay, and also key in the remarks from the PPM. Okay. Now let's see what to do next. Okay, lepas korang key in the SCM summary list, okay, then you guys need to decide, or you guys needs to know whether it is one of these three types. Okay, type yang pertama adalah whether it is where is the cost center comes from, whether is it from the client, which is chargeable, where you need a quotation. Or if it's the cost comes from client, but kita tak boleh charge. Contohnya kita ambil which means that we take the item from client stock, ataupun is it the cost comes from MQ and it is non-chargeable, which is included in the contract. Okay, I give you an example. Contoh kalau client which is chargeable, of course normal lah. Sebab kalau ada benda rosak, kita akan quote client. Ataupun contoh dekat PCMC, whether it's client which is non-chargeable, bila kita pergi ambil, bila belting putus, kita pergi ambil stock daripada client dan kita terus pasang. Okay. Ataupun if it's included in our contract, contoh dekat PCMC, sepatutnya kita buat enzyme coil cleaning satu kali satu tahun. So, this is where the key accounts manager and the site engineer atau site leader needs to know the content of our contract lah. What is our scope of work dekat situ. Okay, if it's client and it's the cost comes from the client and chargeable, okay. Which kita tengok dia pergi kat SCMA. SCMA sini lah, okay. Okay, of course. Then, first of all, the key accounts manager and site engineer pun site coordinator needs to update the cost center in the SCM summary list. Okay, SCM summary list ni yang tadi kan? Okay, sekarang you need to know what you need to do, what is your action plan and also what is your cost center. Okay, jom kita tengok. Okay, kalau bearing bunyi, contoh kita kena replace bearing. Okay, then bila nak kena replace bearing, kita check balik contract. Bearing included tak in the contract? Kalau tak included, which means benda ni kita boleh charge. Okay. So, you need to update in the cost center whether it's chargeable, quotation required. This cost center ada tiga benda ni je. Korang tak payah nak tukar-tukar. Senang. Okay. Contoh kalau PCMC kita kena replace belting. The cost center is client non-chargeable which is client stock. Okay. Kalau enzyme coil cleaning, kos ni termasuk dalam kita punya contract. Okay, jadi untuk isi benda ni, you guys need to know what is included in our work or scope for that particular place lah, particular site. Okay. Lepas dah masuk dalam SCM summary list, you guys need to create the SCM work order lah. This is particularly key accounts manager punya kerja, but site engineer dengan site leader, site coordinator boleh tolong lah. Then, site You guys can need to also fill up the service completion order and delivery order form. Ni attest sekali dengan SCM work order. Okay, starting from now, any breakdown or any SCM, you need to fill in the SCO. This SCO, I believe you guys have seen this lah. Okay, this SCO looks like this. Okay, ada nanti agar ada contoh. Okay, SCO look like that. Then, okay, kalau perlu, okay, kalau perlu, you need to generate. This is of course perlu lah because it's quotation required. When is quotation required, you need to generate a work inspection report. Okay, to generate a quotation. Dia dah generate quotation, you hand over quotation to customer. Customer approve, sign atas quotation lah. Sign atas quotation. Then of course korang kena chase for the PO. Okay, then the key accounts manager and site engineer or site engineer issue order to proceed the work. If you guys need any parts, okay, you raise PR lah. Bila raise PR, okay, so you go to purchasing side. Okay, I'm not gonna go through PR process lah. That gonna take too long. Okay, after that, technician will perform work at site. Then technician kena isi SCM work order dan juga SCM work order dengan SCO. Okay, then of course client akan verify, collect back, lepas tu bagi balik kepada site coordinator. Complete and close lah. After close, korang need to update in the sum release list tadi lah. Maksudnya sum release tadi, bila work on this work order is completed, korang fill in lah berapa hari bulan. Contoh 12/1/2019 contoh lah. Okay, lepas tu this SCM sum release you guys need to include in the monthly report. Okay, as usual, akan generate invoice, DO, and then bill lah. Okay, keadaan yang kedua, kalau it's a non-chargeable, which is from client stock, sama juga, korang update dalam sum release, create work order, site engineer assign technician, technician akan pergi collect parts daripada client, buat kerja, fill in paperwork, dan semuanya sama. Kecuali bila dah habis work order completed, close work order, and then collect data and produce monthly report. Okay, situation yang ketiga where it is non-chargeable, which is included in the contract. Okay, SCM update ini sama juga, update sama release, create SCM work order, assign work order, site leader assign work order, raise PR kalau perlu, perform technician akan perform kerja dekat site. Client akan verify, collect back work order daripada customer, bagi balik semua work order dekat site coordinator. Okay, and then update dalam sum release dan masukkan dalam monthly report. Okay, that's it for SCM. Okay, sekarang kita tengok breakdown.